Hey there, today this will be just a very short video where I'm trying to answer the question of one of my subscribers. In his video, which I will put the link in the video description below, he is trying to repair a Cisco ASA5505 firewall. What he did, first of all, he replaced this chopper transformer here, which, as I have showed you in my video, is really providing the DC voltage to all the components. And then after he replaced the transformer, he finds that he still need to kind of heat up the area around the transformer with a heat gun, and only then his ASA5505 turns on. Well, first of all, I found that such transformers very rarely fail. They are failing less than 1% of the time, so I don't really think that it makes a big sense to replace these. Whenever you heat up an area and something turns on, most of the time the issue is actually with the capacitors. Therefore, in order to solve such issue, I would first of all replace these tantalum capacitors here, and that tantalum capacitor is right there, there is another one. So I would replace these. Since they tend to be quite expensive, you can also put in normal electrolyte capacitors. Of course, take care of the right polarity, as you see here. The polarity is shown also on the tantalum capacitors. There is plenty of space. Even if you put in electrolyte capacitors, it will just work fine. Of course, you need to do a little bit of bodge soldering. That should not be an issue. Nevertheless, you should also replace these two electrolyte capacitors as well. In such case, if you replace these three tantalum caps here and also the two electrolyte capacitors, I would suspect that at least 80% of the time you're gonna repair such fault. And I hope that this is the right solution, because his original video is in French and I don't really understand French, so I hope that I understood his problem properly. If not, then please let me know in the comments below. And also, I hope that this will help out some of the people.